Hello and welcome back to TFS Plays Pokemon Soul Silver Nuzlocke. I'm Lanny Patofarang.
I'm Kyuraptor.
I'm Ash Grant Ninja. By now we'll know who won the Kalos League in the anime, and I hope it was Ash Grant Ninja.
Aw, man.
I believe it was you.
So, we're just going right in?
Never mind. I was going to say, I highly suggest we switch to Flappy.
Price is right!
The price is right.
I don't remember if I healed. The price is right.
I think you did.
The winter trainer, the winter soldier.
It doesn't matter. Like, our son wasn't out first anyway,
that's
so.
Fair enough.
If he's not going to get one-shotted, he can...
Ooh, it's breezy in here.
Yeah, he can one-shot... Okay, he can't fight Seal.
He can't fight level 30 Seal.
No, he can't.
He's too slow.
He can fight the Swinub, though.
Felicity can fight Seal, though.
Felicity can fight this. I think Ivan can kill the Swinub. I'm going to say that.
Maybe.
Because it's going to be ground, and we don't want Felicity in for that.
Definitely, but at that point, Slowmara.
Oh, yeah! No, yes, you're right. Yeah, let's do some more.
Okay, so it hails. Yeah. Hail Caesar.
It's
hail,
whatever.
Hail Seals are.
Oh, Seal isn't an ice type. It's
stupid Seal.
I didn't think it was.
Yeah, I thought it wasn't until Dewgong. Oh,
gotcha.
It's too slow!
Gotcha! Wow,
like a seal out of water!
Jeez, Jesus, how slow is that fucking thing?
Gotcha!
Crap.
You fool!
Good job, you two.
Good job, Felicity. Man, really pulling her weight.
Are they brother and sister?
I'm by adoptive
right,
reasoning.
I mean, they
could bang and like turn out children that weren't
horribly mutilated. Yeah, they wouldn't
but...
be. They'd be fine.
Hello?
Oh!
Woo.
Woo.
Slowmara.
Slowmara, definitely.
Yes, Slowmara can tank this.
Slowmara and just drown this thing. Hopefully it doesn't know Earthquake.
That would be annoying.
That would suck. All right. Not any better.
Blizzard's not great.
Yeah, it's frustrating, but not the worst.
Okay.
Yeah. That's okay. Just don't freeze.
We're gonna get hit.
He's not. Yeah. That's annoying.
Do we want a potion?
I would say just surf right now because
I'm cool with that.
Okay.
Blizzard's accuracy is not great, and so you know, it won't kill.
What else would it have? Like what?
Earthquake is the other big scary thing it might have.
All right, we can potion.
And
just
earthquake
to be sure.
Earthquake would not be.
It wouldn't
super
kill.
It would not be super effective.
They wouldn't kill if they.
It wouldn't
crit,
even be effective.
We're shit
be,
out of luck. Well, but that's always going to be a threat.
Go.
Slowmara's going second, regardless.
Go with your heart, gentlemen.
My heart says surf right now. I want to at least.
Okay,
I want to gauge our damage more than his. There.
Okay.
That's
Mud
good.
Bomb, idiot. Okay, cool.
All right.
That was stronger than I initially anticipated.
Yep.
Remember, we are still going to take damage from hail.
We're not going to die. We're going to take damage. Okay.
Oh, buddy.
All right.
Oh, and she has her berry. Or no, her shell bell.
Yeah.
So that will negate the hail.
Yes. So that.
So did
that.
So did accuracy fall when we got hit by that?
Our accuracy did fall. However, surface 100. So that's not super.
All right. So let's.
I think
potion.
We have
a
hyper.
Yeah. I would say hyper potion.
We have one. I think.
Well, we're using
the time
it
time to use it.
Yeah. This seems like the right time.
It's the right place, right time. And if her stats go too low, we'll just swap her out and swap her back in.
Yeah.
Dwendalyn can eat a hit if somebody needs to take a break.
Yeah, no, Dwendalyn's
gonna
be the one. Fuck, that Mud Bomb hurts so much!
It does.
Okay,
hail
stop.
Surf, I'm just surfing right now.
Yeah, no, surf is the way to go. I almost would have yawned, frankly.
Oh, that might have been good.
Jesus. All right.
Another hyper.
He still has a potion.
He's gonna use a potion, so I would actually say yawn right now. Or
Slowmara
cares.
Baby!
Who cares?
Slowmara, you
Yo!
Our girl, our phantom girl pulled from the other dimension.
Nice!
From deep within the well.
Seven turns in, all took. Dead.
Now we switch back to Felicity.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because Slowmara needs to rest.
Humph, you are quite the
train. Can we switch?
On. If Felicity will eat it, she'll be fine.
She'll be fine.
Anything that they have, Felicity will be okay.
Use pursuit.
God.
That would
break my heart.
Yeah. After that kill, that would have been devastating.
Well, went down swinging.
We believed in her.
Woo!
Jesus.
All right,
so super then thunder. We'll be fine. Because we were at 60.
Yeah.
But not fast. Super. And then we should one-shot it with a thunder. I think we'll one-shot it. If not one-shot, we'll get damn close, then we can do it.
Holy fuck.
You'll get so antsy.
And I'm just saying, Ice Shard, and after this, another Aura Beam, if it procs first.
Well, I can do another super. I say we do another super.
Okay, yeah, just make sure we're at full.
The closest to full we can be. It'll probably do either an Ice Shard or Aurora, whatever.
Okay.
Either way,
so
we attack.
This might not be a popular idea, but what if instead of Thunder out of the gate, you did Thunder Wave? Parallel.
Ooh, just to slow it down.
I like Thunder Wave. That's fine.
Never mind. That's no longer an option.
All right.
The decision was made for us.
Oh, no!
A moment of silence.
Oh, no!
For our beloved Sheepy. Holy shit. You'll be in my heart. You'll be in my heart from this day on.
Now
forever.
Until we deposit you.
That's the shit! That right. was awful.
I'm gonna say.
I make plans for Felicity!
We all did!
She was gonna go to Harvard!
We just painted her room!
Alright.
What? Okay,
we have to move on.
Okay,
we have to move on, boys.
Okay, gather our options.
Slow Mara.
What do we got?
Slow Mara.
No, Slow Mara cannot go in.
No, Slow Mara has to go in.
She can't go in right now.
She can't. She won't eat a hit. This is a free turn. She switches in for free because someone just died. We put her in. We heal her. Nothing Dugong does will kill.
I guess that's right.
Everyone else here is weak to Dugong. This whole party is weak to Dugong.
God damn it!
Slow Mara, this entire bet is on you, baby.
Oh my god.
Do
Please.
We have a max potion?
Yeah, I'm sorry. This is happening. I don't want to risk any of this shit.
Oh my god.
I'm not losing you, baby.
Not today.
Your sister died valiantly.
Oh my god.
Because yeah, Aurora Beam's going to be the best thing it can do, and that's going to be frustrating, but not the worst.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
Shadow Ball or Yawn? Yawn or Shadow Ball? Which do we suggest? Because we can put it to sleep and then shadow the fuck out of it.
Does it have a full restore or Hyper Potion? What do you think?
I would see a Hyper Potion right now.
I see
now,
Hyper Potion.
So
I'm yawning.
Yawning.
So yawn.
We can eat another hit.
Yeah, we can eat another hit. Pop a super, we'll be fine.
And the only thing Aurora Beam can do, it can't freeze. It can only lower attack.
Yeah.
Which it isn't.
It doesn't matter. That doesn't matter to us.
Yeah, we don't give a fuck. Don't give a fuck.
Cool. We'll heal at the end of this turn. He'll be asleep.
Or do we want to wail on confusion? Stab and the chance to confuse it.
Hang on, the strongest thing it has is Aurora Beam, right?
It can
as far as we know.
So even if it crits, then we're fine. This has been two. This is two Aurora Beams, correct?
Yes. Yeah, that was two.
Okay.
It's only done 45.
I'm gonna confuse. We're fine. Mathematically,
okay.
we are fine.
We're okay.
Go to bed.
This won't do much damage, but
didn't do it right. Would have seen by now.
Yeah.
Okay, whatever.
It's asleep, though. Do we Shadow Ball or, like, what are the odds of it waking up turn one? Zero?
It can wake up the next turn. That is possible.
Then I say
it's like a 1 in 10 chance.
We need to give her a potion.
Shit. I'm sorry.
No, that's fine.
We'll just heal here and then attack next turn, and by then, we'll be good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it can't kill us right
no,
now. Not off one hit.
There's nothing it can do. Cool.
Okay, so Shadow Ball.
Yeah, Shadow Ball might be better because Shadow Ball can lower defense.
Why does it know that?
All right.
This thing is a nightmare.
This fucking Dugong no sleep.
Another talk. Super potion. Another super potion.
Why does this Dugong no sleep talk?
Why did Felicity have to die? God damn it! Leaving us hanging here, girl!
We have to kill it without him popping the potion.
That's why we just gotta keep, like, whenever we get a chance, we just have to... Fuck her. Fuck you.
Of course.
Fuck you, you son of a
okay,
bitch.
Okay, that's fine. That's the better of the
piece
two.
Piece of shit. This Dugong is a monster.
I know. This is the scariest thing we've encountered, and I don't...
Ever.
Remember this.
Shadow Ball.
Yeah, Shadow Ball.
The
okay.
only thing we can do. Ah, you idiot! Ah! Eat shit,
you
stupid idiot! You know what? Yawning might still be the best.
This thing has solid defense, guys. Yawn again.
No.
Well,
it has sleep talk. That's a end game.
Here's the thing.
That matters.
It's like it's going to sleep talk, but every one in however many turns it's going to take to wake up, that's going to be a wasted move.
A wasted
and
turn. Okay.
And otherwise, it's just going to keep using Aurora Beam. We're just going to have to keep super.
Well, let me just tell you this: if our wasted turn is then wasted using Yawn for the turn that they waste to,
yeah,
so
that's
it evens.
It's,
okay,
it's,
fair enough.
It evens. So I think.
Of course, that being said, Sleep Talk also has the potential to do Ice Shards, which does less damage.
That I suppose that's true.
I'd say just confusion.
I think going for the
coin flip on confusion might be.
Going for the coin flip on confusion, or should we go for like
the defense drop on Shadow Ball?
Well, defense.
Is it defense or special defense? Okay,
because
that's good.
The special defense on Shadow Ball might be what saves our ass.
Or it knows Sleep Talk,
Aurora Beam, Ice Shards,
and question mark.
Still one mystery.
It's probably
recover.
Something that puts it to sleep. It's gotta be. What else would it be?
Yeah, rest maybe?
Rest maybe? Because if that's the case, ice moves will not be very effective on Dwendalin, while rollout will be super effective on this.
It doesn't know a water move.
Yeah.
Well, no, we don't know that.
We don't know what that mystery fourth move is. It could be a water move.
Does Dwendalin have sturdy?
No.
I say just Shadow Ball for right now.
All right.
Regardless, the special defense drop is something that we need to count on.
I agree. Like, we do need to get that down. I'm okay with that.
And we can keep eating super potions like every other turn.
Yeah, this is fun. Okay, even a crit Aurora Beam, we're good. So we can do another one.
God, fuck you.
Okay, whatever. Let's do another one.
We are doing 10 health or less. This always does 10% of whatever damage you did.
Okay.
I am liking this, though. This is an actual challenge.
Yeah.
But it is a very frustrating and scary challenge.
This is the point. This is what a Nuzlocke is supposed to invoke. We hit it. We hit the point.
All right, now we need a super potion.
And we do...
We got 14 left.
14 of these things.
That's fine.
We should have more than enough.
We're not going to lose this. It's just if we are going to not lose a child. I don't lose anybody.
Oh, my God. I can't believe that happened.
Crits, man. Crit happens.
Okay. Keep Shadow Ball. We just need to drop its special defense some way, somehow, somewhere, someday.
If you got that fucking Thunder Wave off, this wouldn't be nearly as much of a problem.
Right?
Yep.
All you're doing is dropping a regular attack. Fuck you, we don't have any regular attacks.
God.
You little fucker! What is the, like...
It's gotta be, like, 1 in 4, maybe. Willow is my middle name. Willow is flexible and
that
not
means,
easily
that
broken.
Mean, does that mean he's gonna use a potion?
No.
Regardless, we have to.
Yeah, we have to. He's not going to use a potion. It's when they're, I think, at a
in the
third.
Red? Because that's a third.
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, he might use a potion, but either way.
Either way, it's a...
Yeah, okay, it is rest. So
okay,
Dwendalin's fine.
So Dwendalin is fine.
Do we want to do that? Roll out?
I like that idea.
Fuck it.
Because
what else do we got to lose?
The roughest part about this is Aurora Beam goes on special defense. Dwendalin's special defense is not good. So even though it's hitting for neutral damage,
it'll be a lot.
But
she'll probably die.
It's very possible. And we don't have self-destruct anymore, sadly.
So we can stick with Slowmara.
I
want to stick with her for a bit.
Actually, now that I think about it.
Okay.
Without any water moves, would he affect Ivan Ooze?
Ivan Ooze has Ancient Power, which is a rock move.
But isn't that part water? Wouldn't that part water, like, just not affect it?
It would neutralize it at best.
At that point, I still want to stick with Slowmara with our Shadow Ball strat.
Because Ivan Ooze has better special attack than Slowmara.
Ancient Power would do more than whatever Slowmara would do.
Ancient Power would be doing more per hit. Ancient Power does only have 5 PP. But Ancient Power also has the chance to, like, a 1 in 10 chance to up every stat of the user.
I'm also going to say this. I think we need to stick with her just to get the stat effects.
I want at least one of them if we can.
Okay, that's fine.
Does Sleep Talk have its own PP? And if it runs out, like, you can't do anything anymore? Do you know how much it is? Like, 10?
The fucking luck of getting Aurora Beam. That did not hurt as much as it usually does.
Well, it's not really that much of a luck. It's 50-50 because it can't...
It can't
sleep
use,
talk
it,
rest.
It can't sleep talk rest?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't sleep talk rest. You can't sleep
one of
talk
these
sleep
has
talk.
One of these has to do it. One of these has to.
Probability would be in your favor there?
I'd hope.
It could be an ability Dugong has that I'm not thinking about that, like, blocks stat changes. But
yeah, but that would have shown up.
Yeah, it would have.
Fuck you, you piece of shit!
This has to be really low.
We can probably make it to, like... How much damage has it been doing per turn?
It's been doing around 20-something.
And it's going to wake up eventually, so yeah. It's going to waste a turn.
Sleep Talk has 10 PP, by the way.
Yeah! Fuck
yes!
Idiot!
There it is. Sleep Talk has 10?
Yeah.
It's used at least 5 times.
Okay. Just once!
This is absurd! Because it has rest and another... We might be running out of potions if we keep doing this. It has rest and another potion, and we're whittling it down like nothing.
I can't believe that none of these have affected its special.
I'm digging the Dwayne strat. The other thing I might pose is to pop another yawn to make it run out of sleep talk.
We can do that.
Because that's right now.
So pop a yawn, run to Dwayndolin, and then
I want to
roll out.
Do a yawn right now, switch to Dwayndolin, and then start rollout.
All
right.
Right? I think that works.
Because I would say that or...
Because then it has a chance to get Ice Shard, not Aurora Beam. That'd be the best time to switch.
Alright, now we swap.
Yeah, now we're going to switch.
It's going to eat one hit. It's going to eat one Aurora Beam.
Yeah.
Hopefully
which
it can... Hopefully
it
should
be
survive.
Able to survive.
Because we got to bank on that, like...
It's just pure rock, right? Not rock ground?
It's rock ground, but it should be neutral damage.
Well, it crit.
Or it gets crit.
Okay.
Oh, my God!
Fuck me. Types. But hey, it's asleep.
Ivan time or... I'm so scared for our baby boy.
Our baby boy has to earn his stripes! Do it, Ivan!
It's ancient power it all day.
Would
Quick
Fire
claw.
Blast also
Quick
be neutral?
Claw.
And he's got yawn too. Ivan might save this. It was just your
birthday
our
number
party.
One. You're our number one.
Ah, yeah!
Talk rest.
You son of a bitch!
Yes!
Oh! Yeah! Our baby boy's going super saiyan!
Saiyan Ivan!
Hit him! Kill him!
Okay.
He's gonna use a potion.
I know, he's gonna use his potion.
All
right. Suck!
Let's see how much damage this does.
Yeah.
This is the curiosity.
Hold on.
Okay, that's not bad.
Woo! That's good!
He's
even
really
crit,
good.
Even crit, we're fine.
Yeah. Murder it. Oh, just keep throwing ancient power.
Just another ancient power. Okay, it's a hyper.
So it's gonna heal up.
It's gonna heal up.
We have something.
Come on! We have a strat!
And we have an ether if we need it on ancient power.
Yeah!
You stupid
fuck!
Fucked! Oh my god. Come on.
He's gonna rest again. So ancient
quick
power
claw,
again.
Quick claw!
Quick claw!
Quick claw!
Quick!
Yeah! That's our boy! That's our boy! That's our boy! Yeah! Take that, you murderer!
Holy shit!
Fuck you!
Oh my god!
God!
Yes!
Oh.
Yes!
Fuck you, Price! You murdered our favorite sheep!
G fucking G, Price! Holy hell!
You sack of garbage! We wasted thunder now!
Oh yeah, we did buy that TM. Oh well.
Oh my god!
Yes, we are worthy of this badge!
Woo! That was the most intense fight I think we've had this entire run.
This entire run, most certainly. Yeah.
And this is a gift from me.
Fuck you, just Tantor slaps him in the face.
My.
Knocks his old ass out. Well, hey guys, this is the 7th gym. We still have the 5th and 6th to fight, so.
Well, hey, those are supposedly lower, right?
That would be
the
rumor.
I think they're around the same level.
Oh my god.
Our number one baby boy, proving.
Proving
boy, like, shadow
tough.
Without shadow of a doubt.
Yeah. Our true son. Now, if ever there was doubt, let it be known that he is our true son.
And we have no daughter.
Ivan.
Oh, great! Mom's calling.
Good. Hi, baby job. Boy. Oh.
We missed
Mom. Oh, fuck! We didn't miss Mom.
Oh,
Kyle.
Shoot!
Oh, well.
Oh, well.
It's her telling us that she bought more stuff with our
I'm
money.
Certain.
Well, I haven't time to... I don't want you to have to see this, baby, but, you know, it's just...
This is look, part of life.
It sucks, but...
I know you're going to miss your sister, Felicity.
It's real...
And you might miss Dwendolyn a little bit.
Who?
Who?
She hasn't been around, like, one of the longest.
Yeah, she's...
She pulled her fucking weight!
She was, like, the third
did.
Pokemon we caught.
She pulled her weight until the ice beam fucking murdered the fuck out of her.
Well, Dwendolyn, it's been fun.
Sort of. I mean...
You did... She did great!
I'm trying to remember things that she actually did.
Got us through that whole normal-type gym, practically. Like,
yeah,
that whole
yeah,
fight.
Yeah,
that
yeah, whole, that's true.
Beating the mill tank was because of her.
Yeah, that's right. That's true. You
Not
did
to
your
mention
job.
The first gym and the second gym. The first three gyms were all Dwendolyn.
Okay, she did her job.
Good job, Dwendolyn.
You've earned your rest.
Rest in peace.
You will not be missed.
You won't be missed. Who was that? Who fucking cares? Yeah,
doesn't matter.
Felicity.
Now we work towards...
high hopes, but disappointment
unfortunately,
comes to all parents.
Maybe we'll find an Ampharos later down the line and we'll remember you.
But probably not.
Probably not. I don't think they're
probably
wrong.
Not.
Rest in peace, Felicity.
All right, so looking
you
to
will
the
not
future.
Be missed.
Who do we
yep,
replace?
We gotta swap in.
You?
Good all news. Right. A slot just opened back up for our favorite owl.
A slot did open... Oh, yeah. A slot did open up for our favorite owl. We also have Brandon Lee and Ric Flair over in the daycare.
We do. Well, Brandon Lee isn't in the daycare. He's right there.
Oh, no. Who is in the daycare, then? It's Ric Flair and someone else.
I honestly... Did we...
Don't remember.
I don't remember who it is.
Who the fuck did we put in that daycare?
I don't know. All right, so... Beefy Bevy is going to hard cap Machoke.
Hard cap there, yeah.
Beefy Bevy I was mostly thinking about for the gym we just fought, so... Like,
so that
really,
doesn't matter.
Really, like,
so whatever.
Yeah. Because
that's not of use. We already have our fire type.
Yeah, we already have our fire type, so we're good.
Brandon Lee is okay. I really
like. I like Allie as well. Man Crobat fills everything Allie would do.
It's true. God damn it! If only she didn't have such an amazing name.
Yeah, I know. I like Budge. I'm gonna tell you why I like Budge. He's gonna be Bug Steel.
He's gonna be hurt by fire, but
fire
not
will
much
fuck
else.
His shit up, but nothing else really will touch him.
And then we got what's Hoplip turn into?
Hoplip turns into it is also gonna be a grass flying when it turns into Jumpluff.
We could bring Hymni out and maybe get an Umbreon.
That's true.
We could get an Umbreon.
I do like dark types,
but Man Crobat will has that covered. Like Man Crobat
is Man Crobat dark?
He has
bite and
which
can,
he's
yeah, but
doing
that
really
means he
good.
Has bite
and
he's
can
not
get
a...
crunch and is faster than Umbreon.
The only thing that Umbreon would be good in. That he would do significantly better than Man Crobat is he would be able to switch into psychic moves and not be affected
not,
at
yeah,
all.
Yeah, not be hurt by him.
What other evolutions would we possibly want? I mean, obviously we're down an electric type now.
Jolteon, I suppose.
Jolteon is good.
I wonder since we just beat this gym if we can go to the ice cave that's across from here and perhaps get a Sneasel.
I would die.
Or a Swinub. Or a Delphine.
If we got a Sneasel, I'm sorry. That's happening.
Well, that's fine. It can be in the party. I don't
I
care.
Would love a Sneasel.
But right now, we just
so,
need to...
So, here's the thing. Really while Noctowlie McBeal has most of her roles covered by Man Crobat, mm-hmm. the next gym we're going up against is a fighting type gym.
Oh, that's true.
Oh,
that's
right.
It would be
okay.
good to have a second flyer.
I'm cool with that.
She would be
I'm
great
fine
there.
With that. Right
she,
now,
she
I can't
think of anyone she can be Goose to, you know... Yeah, she can be Goose.
I like Budge. I also like Ric Flair. He's been in that daycare a while. He will
pick.
Probably be pretty comparable stat-wise, and he gets the move Earthquake very early.
Yeah.
If he still knows it.
Does anyone else jump out as, like, really,
the
really
only
good?
The only other one I'm thinking of is the Eevee, and that's only for, like the possibilities, you know what
yeah.
I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, Hymni has been sitting in there for a while. Brandon Lee, I mean, Haunter's
the
just, Haunter's just
yeah,
not as good.
They are not that good.
If we could get a Gengar, maybe,
yeah, then it'd be
but
different
we can't.
Story. I'd pull for Budge in the interim. I think Budge would do better than...
That's cool, but it's also level 4.
I know.
We just have to put him up front and swap him out. Like, it's going to be a pain in the ass,
yeah.
but... other than that, until we catch something better.
Coughing does have Levitate. That would be a
Coughing
free
has
switch
levitate.
In on ground types.
Weezing isn't bad. But we also have Crobat.
Crobat.
Man
Crobat.
Man Crobat covers a lot of this.
This is hard choice. I say just take Budge for now, and we'll let
I'm saying Budge for now.
Yeah, we'll go to the daycare and see if we like see who else is in there with Ric Flair. Who is Ric Flair tormenting?
All or day. Being tormented by? Who knows?
All right, heal us up. We had a long fucking day. Holy shit!
Look, we this has been a sad day for us. So, just fucking do it. God, I can't believe two.
Yeah, that fight was
not since Brock.
Yeah,
have we lost that many in a gym.
I like just yesterday we were talking about how like we're not hurting for Pokemon. If people die, we'll be fine. And now they've died, and we're like, what do we do? Here, go the other way. Go the other way. I want to see if we're allowed to go this way or if it hard locks you to needing 6 badges. Yep.
Ah, it's probably a
kid. You're not.
Get out of here! I'm gonna push your bike. Who the fuck do you think you are? We are Tantor. Tantor uses the royal we.
We are Tantor.
Okay, and that ice cave is that way, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, because I thought Sneasel like shows up naturally on like level 38, level 40, so.
Well, it definitely wouldn't be that high because the Elite Four is level 40.
Really?
Yeah.
I forgot how low they are.
Well, remember, they have to be lower because we have an entire other region to go to.
I guess technically the Elite Four is a little bit higher than that.
Oh, Budge isn't up front. Our bad.
No, well,
you're slow. You're slow, remember?
I forgot I'm slow.
Okay.
Fuck. No.
No. No. Mistake.
Budge! Well,
go
Budge
train!
Did.
I mean, I'm glad, like, looking at what it did, a crit would not have killed us, but that would have been spooky.
I would have laughed really hard.
Then I would have pulled for Vulpix, because Vulpix learns Flamethrower.
Yeah.
No.
I mean, we do have a backup, but he's our number one boy.
Oh, yeah.
We have a backup for our
saved,
favorite Charles.
He saved that gym.
Yeah.
Let's get him out of the front.
whatever, we can hit him later. Budge! We're gonna have an impenetrable fortress that will never budge.
Budge.
Yes, we do know what the word budge means.
Budge is a word?
What? Really?
Wow, what does it mean?
It means not moving.
Huh.
Or a slight move, rather. Like, like you budge.
You budge. Just move slightly. Look at it. You think he's budging? Is he actively budging?
Is he budging?
We will not budge on this issue.
What do you say, budge?
Looking down.
He's not budging.
He's not budging on his stance. He's looking down steady. He's got a good poker face. By the way, for those of you that don't know, that is called sarcasm. I did know that budge was a word.
What?
Yeah.
I don't You're sending too many mixed signals. This doesn't.
I can't follow you guys anymore.
So I know we talked about this in private, but I want to say this. I feel like this is a better time than any, except for on the stream.
Sure.
So the first Kingdom Hearts stream, there's a moment where I said, if only there was a phrase I could say from this franchise that involves committing things to memory. I can't think of what it is, though. I can't remember it.
Yeah.
And then there were like 100 comments saying, got it memorized.
Yeah, you're thinking of got it memorized.
Yeah, you're thinking of Axel's got it memorized.
The joke is, I know what it is. You know what it is. It's called an inference, and we both know it.
I don't understand.
I don't have it memorized.
You got that.
What are you doing?
Run!
What are you doing? We put him up front.
That was an accident. That was an honest-to-God accident. I meant to hit Pokemon.
If he died, I would have laughed my fucking ass off.
It's like, you fought for him!
And not cared for the rest of my days. Send Allie in. She hasn't had love in a bit.
No, I already picked it.
All right.
You gotta speak up fast. Faster than Mancrobat.
We have to see Allie. Allie has not been on the... He's a flying type. That shouldn't affect him. Anyway.
Faster than Mancrobat?
When it's being quick.
Yeah, when it uses a move that's automatically faster.
But it's not nearly as quick when it's being dead.
Good job, Budge.
Good work, Budge. You're getting there.
Champion.
Budge might need to go to the daycare.
Champion of my heart. No, we can grind him off screen, honestly.
Yeah, we could get him up there.
It's easy for you guys to say. I'm the one who does the grinding.
Yeah. We can grind him off screen. Hey, that'd be a really cool effect. We can do that. Yeah, we can, says me.
Kieran.
All I'm saying is we have a batch of recording to do.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, we do. Alright, Dan.
Peek behind that veil.
Fuck!
Just get him out of there and hope it's not someone who can no pursuit. Or he'll just teleport away.
Budge!
What?
Just keep him in, right?
Yeah.
All he knows is teleport.
Yeah, he only knows teleport.
Fuck you, I'll get you! You're too slow, Budge!
Come on, Budge!
You're not moving.
You're not even trying.
Yes, a fire would kick his ass. What else?
No, ground would be neutral.
He's got steel, which I think covers a lot of the things that attack Bug.
I think water would be... I can't remember if water's...
Water does not hurt steel.
Water's neutral.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then no.
The only thing he'd be really weak against, I think, is fire or psychic.
He'd be neutral to flying.
Fire and maybe fighting.
Yeah, fighting.
Does fighting beat Bug?
I think it's neutral on Bug.
Okay, so yeah, we just 2 times and 4 times for those two. Okay.
What about ground? Does Bug hurt ground?
Bug is not very affected against ground, so it
would
be neutral.
Where the fuck am I going, by the way?
You're going to the daycare. Down.
Okay.
Come on, man. Get your head in the game. We just fought a big
gym. Right here. Ah.
Sorry,
there's no brakes!
There's no brakes on
no brakes on this pain train!
I need to head the deck, Alex, easy start!
Where are we going again?
Just throw the bike at the dude.
Run into the drowsy.
Yeah, you threw the bike at the drowsy, and then the drowsy's like, I'm pissed. And you're like, go, Budge! I mean, go, Owly McBeal!
Yeah, Owly got it.
Come on, give us that look, girl. Give us that look.
Give us that look!
That over the shoulder! I've been waiting for you.
Do it.
You left me in a box. She's flipping out because this is her first time out free. She spread her wings.
The sun! I'm a nighttime bird!
The sun's setting, you're fine.
Yeah, Budge is level 5.
Budge!
Budge is as good as the first Pokemon we got.
Oh, hang on, we got
Mom.
Blew her off last time.
Tantor, sweetie.
What? Hi, Mom, hi. How are you doing?
Hi, Tantor, how are you?
I'm doing good, just lost a few friends.
What were their names?
I already forgot it.
I got you another item from the shop when I was out.
You know what the delivery man said, Mom?
What did he say, sweetie?
He said that she walked in and you laughed.
Yep.
And you just laughed at her.
I don't know.
Go to hell, Mom.
Man, that was a rough conversation.
Yeah, wow.
Who's Tantor's sister? Find out in the finale.
I feel uncomfortable.
Has Ric Flair just been here by himself?
Oh, poor Ric Flair.
Oh, Ric Flair, no! I'm sorry! Hang on. We gotta fix this.
Budge, take a seat.
Ric Flair needs to get home. Come home.
Party. Budge.
Get in there. We'll grind you up later, little buddy.
Yeah, we'll come back for you.
Oh, Slamara, we let her into the world.
Uh-oh. Shit!
Oh, it's good to.
Her eyes roll into the back of her head, starts screeching.
Yes, we can afford that.
Jesus, ripoff.
Yay!
You grew 23 levels. I think that's pretty good.
So, what's up?
What level is he?
Holy
Jesus Christ! How?
Ric Flair!
How does... That's more than... But...
Look at the last gen! Oh my god!
Little piece of shit. Rain dance.
Yeah,
rain dance. Rain dance, Rick. Rick.
Teach it surf.
I know your style and your profile, but come on.
Rain dance, Rick.
What did they teach you at this camp? Should he have leveled by now?
He should definitely have evolved.
Yeah.
He evolves at 20.
What moves did we miss?
Woo!
Woo! Woo! Alright, well, this will just be for a sec. So.
Let's let him walk around for a bit.
Yeah, this will just be for a second. So let's do, we can put 2 people in here. Who do we want in?
Who are we,
I think Budge could probably go in. Do you want Budge in here or do you want someone else that we need? Because I think we should actively grind him later.
We want to actively get him, evolved properly.
I think...
We could let, then again, we miss out on the evolution.
No, they won't evolve.
Well, no, I mean, we won't miss out on the evolution. Mm-hmm. We will miss out on, the moves that they would learn when they evolve. And then level up.
Yeah.
So maybe Beefy Bevy, maybe.
Yeah, I'm thinking maybe Beefy Bevy and
I was gonna say Slugbo and whatever the fuck we called Poliwag.
Crack.
Yes. Man, we do not have a high opinion of Poliwag.
Well, here's the thing with good old Crackass. We have 2 really strong water Pokemon. What's he gonna do?
Okay, fair enough. How about
Slugbo is a backup, and we do not have a rock type or a ground type anymore. Well, we have Ric Flair, but we don't have a rock type anymore.
Ivan's gonna have rock.
That's true.
Put Houdini in there regardless.
Yeah, I'm cool with putting Houdini in there if there's
some dishonorable cur should come up and take away another Pokemon from us. At least we'll have something in the, like, wings.
Yeah, yeah.
This was our plan with Meowthew that never panned out.
Yes. Well, it didn't pan out. He just failed his test.
He did. He failed horribly.
He gave him the entrance exam and he was booted out.
All right, Houdini, try not to escape, okay?
Yeah, we're gonna come back and be like, "Oh, your Houdini's gone."
He escaped the first night.
How do you lose an 18-foot rock snake?
I don't even know. We are a very bad daycare. Worst in the world, actually.
So it's real unfortunate.
Samara's just staring at me with her dead eyes.
It's unfortunate that Felicity died when she did.
Yeah. It's unfortunate because she died in general.
Particularly because I was going to suggest this be our next route to go to, because there's an area we can surf to where it's a bunch of people with water Pokemon to just grind on.
But
instead, I'm going to say let's have Mr. Steak run some train.
Yeah, because Mr. Steak needs to get to his final form.
Yeah.
And then we'll grind fudge later. So that'd be a good move.
So I'd say before we go where we want to go after this,
slow.
Let us first move to the water that is to our left.
Okay.
Oh, Jesus. This has been an adventure
today.
Yeah,
this is an eventful day. Over here?
Yep.
Right here?
Just swim down south from here. We have our own little mini water type Elite Four.
Mistake!
Who?
A little mini water type Elite Four.
Does this count?
There's a group of swimmers.
No, doesn't matter.
Does this count?
We
headbutted here.
Yeah, we headbutted here. That's right.
You're right.
So, murder it. Magical leaf. They're magic. I just imagine when he flutters them off, he's just staring at them like
he's like,
like blowing bubbles,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah.
And then they shred through the Pokemon like razors.
Oh god!
And he's just smiling. He looks over at Tantor.
Do good?
Tantor just grimaces. Nice.
Yo!
Yeah, we're rich!
Look at that.
Give me the nuggets.
Give me that nug.
Yeah, noobs.
Sweet crispy nougat.
What is down here? Let's see.
Oh! Oh
man, this looks
triple battle!
This looks shady as fuck.
Oh, I guess it's an Elite 3. Oh, we're gonna do a double battle. And regular ass gold and silver was one at a time.
Oh.
Hey ladies!
Oh man!
How you doing? Oh, this is these are the right two.
Biggest Shadow Ball star, you.
Yeah, because Surf would hit
Magic Leaf,
Surf
Goldene.
Would hit Mr. Steak, so.
Yeah.
So yeah, makes sense to me.
Slow.
Ha-cha!
Mr. Steak. Steak.
He's so happy.
He's too happy.
We should stop.
Yeah, we gotta fix that.
Wait, Swift hits both?
Oh, that's lame.
I mean, it doesn't matter. So he's gonna fucking die regardless. Womp. What does it make of that? What does it make of its last moments on Earth? What the fuck? I thought, oh, never mind. It's Star Me that's part
that adds the psychic.
Oh, is Star Me psychic? I thought Star You was psychic as well.
Regardless.
Well, it's also not Stab and Slowmara's special attack. It's not good.
True.
Me is in Confusion.
Well, Confusion will be...
It's not psychic.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I feel like this will kill. Oh, it's like 50. Except
well,
no
or
not.
Anymore. Well.
Chica!
Chica-chica!
Ow.
Slowmara don't give a fuck.
Slowmara's just like, I do what I do. Hey!
Finally!
Yeah.
Where was that, like, half an hour ago?
Could've used that earlier, but no big.
Ain't a thing. Are you gonna Shadow Ball Seeking instead?
No, I'm switching it up. Because Magic Leaf will absolutely kill Star You. And then we can Confusion the Seeking and I'll kill him.
Ah, yes.
Because I want that thing doing a recover, because Slowmara's too slow.
That's fair.
Ooh.
Ouch.
Jesus. Look at that, you stupid fuck.
I was a meme once. Mistake!
Might want to heal Mr. Steak and set a Shadow Ball, Starmie.
Does this thing have anything that would actually hurt Mr. Steak? Oh, wait. It might.
Yeah.
This motherfucker could know Flamethrower.
Could learn Aurora Beam, I think.
I don't think switching is necessary. I'm just going to say...
Give him a potion?
Because it won't be stabbed, so whatever it does will not be super strong.
That's true.
There you go, Mr. Steak. Don't say we never done anything good for you. We picked you. So, I mean, you were forced upon
us. Yeah, no. We didn't pick you. I vied for you. I loved you from the start.
We could be sitting here...
with a shitty Totodile.
No. It would be its next
Croconaw.
Wow. That's got a lot of special defense.
Again, Slamar's special attack is garbage, and we're not
Mr. Steak's magical leaf with that will be fine, though.
Like, I think you guys are overestimating. Like, we have the worst possible nature with a Pokemon that is meant for physical attack, not special attack. Like,
which is weird to me, considering every time I've seen like Slowbro, it's always
Slowbro is special attack.
Oh, okay.
It switches when it evolves.
Yeah. So once we're Bro Mara, then the tables have turned and we'll be unstoppable.
Yeah.
And then this next one's just going to attack us right away.
Yes.
Because Slowking, I believe, is the physical evolution. Like, he's more physical
than
special. That's from what I remember.
No, he's both.
Thank God we didn't initiate that. See this really quick.
Come on, Mr. Steak.
That's the Mara thing.
Yeah, our girl first. Ladies first.
Then the gym.
Actually, wait. Got these.
Are you going to give it to him?
He already has one, I think.
He's never eaten it.
Oh no, he's got the...
Yeah, he's got the...
Leaf thing.
Leaf thing, whatever.
Alright.
He's fine.
Thanks for walking the extra step.
I must pay you back for defeating my sisters.
Hey, Kate. How you doing, girl?
Black and White had triple battles, right?
Yes.
That was a nightmare.
Yeah, I was not a fan of those.
I like the rotation ones. Those are really cool.
Slice.
It's a kind of magic.
You ever get a paper cut on your tongue? That's what he died of.
Ew.
There you go, Mr. Steak.
Tongue pain always got to me with that one Happy Tree Friends episode with the ant eater.
Oh,
Remember that one?
Yeah.
I think I saw that one.
That's bad.
This guy's ice.
I don't want this. I do not want. I'd say Slamara is the best bet. Because we're clearly get fucked up.
She clearly proved her... she proved herself in that last gym. And she's unlike that last gym, she's three levels above this one, so...
Yeah.
Shadow Ball, I guess? Confusion? Shadow Ball?
Confusion would at least be Stab.
Yeah, Confusion, Stab. Ah!
Sucker. Fuck her!
Protect is worthless if you don't have a fucking status going.
Idiot.
You dummy! Hey, it's damage.
That's more damage than you can do to a Cloyster. How big do you think Cloyster is?
I thought we established it was like 5 feet tall.
Did we look at Cloyster?
I thought we looked at Cloyster.
I don't remember looking at Cloyster. I remember looking at Ghastly. That was like a 4 foot ball.
Yeah, a 4 foot ball of vapor.
Not including the gas. Oh my god!
Once again, Shepherd Shang sending us this book. All sorts of Pokemon. Facts.
Knowledge and factoids.
Pokemon. You don't know these by dex number by heart? What's wrong with you?
There it is.
I do, it's just I wasn't looking at the number. Alright, what would you guess Cloyster's height is?
I guessed 5 feet.
I think it is 3.5.
4'11".
I was very close. I was over, so I lose.
Weighing 292 pounds.
Holy hell!
Damn, That's slightly less than the most I've ever weighed. Like, I think the most I've ever weighed is 295.
Really?
Yeah, currently I'm down to 245. I'm very proud of myself.
Yeah, that's good.
What did they give us?
They gave us
worthless
this thing.
Power herbs.
Okay.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, it lets you not have to charge a move like Solar Beam or something.
Oh, that would be so useful!
But exactly
it's
once.
One time. Yeah, it's a
that'd be
time
so move useful once.
Yeah, we might save that for,
Lakiger.
Yeah, for the final battle.
Oh, man!
It's getting dark.
Time!
Time, it's of the essence.
We gotta go. We gotta go do something else.
We don't know fly yet, do we?
Nope, I think we
skipped the area for that.
Oh, Jesus. Well, let's go to that one next.
Yeah, we should get that.
What gym is fly?
I think is it Olivine?
Could be Cyanwood, could be Olivine.
Well, we will find out this time.
Well,
or not.
Well, probably not. It's a little
bit
ways.
Process of elimination wise.
Get out of here, dude.
What?
Mr. Steak?
Remember, part poison.
Is it because poison?
Yeah,
poison. That's right.
Part poison neutralizes
it. Oh, really? Well, then fuck this.
And tentacle are
Mr. Steak!
All about that special D.
Whip! I just imagine him sticking, like, slamming his head in the water, like... You know who he reminds me of?
Comes up chewing on a jellyfish.
Yeah, he reminds me of Ed.
From Ed and Eddie. Yeah.
Single D?
Yeah, single D Ed. Like that episode where he's being a woodpecker outside and slamming his
head
against the ground.
Slap.
That's Mr. Steak.
I am a woodpecker, yeah. But with dirt.
Yeah, that's Mr. Steak. Done.
I remember that one episode where they were trying to stay ahead of trends.
Yes!
Yeah.
And there's the scene where Ed, it's the only scene where like he looks smart or like cool, is when he's got the stupid fucking clothes hangers on his
like,
ears.
Like
the facial expression he makes is just like, it's the only time you ever look like see him looking confident, I feel.
Yeah.
Nah, he knows he's got it going on.
I'd say that in the episode where he...
Oh, he's trying to wrap himself around Mr. Steak's neck.
What a fool mistake.
Mr. Steak's just gonna slap him into the side of the riverbank.
Yeah, you're done. You don't want to be stuck on his head. You do not want that anywhere near you. It's a weapon.
Yeah, that's the part where he is least vulnerable.
Let me wrap myself around your sword, is what you're saying.
Mr. Steak, Mr. Steak, Steak, Steak.
He is Ed.
What level is he at? 29?
28, I think.
Okay.
So four levels?
Yeah, four levels away.
We're getting there.
Soon Mr. Steak's final form shall be realized.
We're gonna be crossing the ocean as our next quest, so he'll have plenty to do.
Something that I never thought would happen. I thought he would die by now.
I know! You all were wanting it!
Everybody expected him to be dead by now, but now he's still around!
From the start, I had Mr. Steak's back. I had him from the
start. You had it from the start.
I had it from the start.
You can go back and check it. He's the one you wanted.
I want someone to go back and check, and it's like your...
Oh, I still hated him, but
we all hated him, but you wanted
it. But I wanted
it. You wanted something to hate.
Yes, I did. I needed an excuse to hate something, but how can I hate this?
Mr. Steak!
Look at him!
Let's go to the store real quick and check on the delivery man that
let's see what mom got us this time.
Talk to him a couple times because I think we've missed the last few. Look at that, silk scarf. That's pretty good.
That's good for normal type moves,
yeah,
right?
I think so, yeah.
Shucka berries.
Shucka.
Feel good.
The moonstone.
Cool.
If only...
Rest in peace, salad fork.
Salad fork.
Too little, too late.
All right, so Cyanwood is north, right?
I think? It's to the...
I'm just going to pull up the map.
We got a map.
It's the west of Ycratique.
I'm the map. There's the map. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Now we can see him because we saw him. Let's see.
And apparently we can also see Entei. I guess we didn't even need to...
Well, we met him at... Like, he's the one that... Oh, wait, no. Suicune was the one that walked up to
us. Yeah. I didn't know we could see all of them from the front. Oh, well. That's Olivine is...
Cyanwood is across the ocean.
Oh, Cyanwood's over...
So we have to go to Olivine first.
We have to go to Olivine, but we can't fight the gym because the Ampharos at the lighthouse is sick.
And then
so we have to go to Cyanwood, the pharmacy.
We should go steal that Ampharos.
If only we could.
I just want a Team Rocket mod where it's just like, nah, I'm just going to take your Pokemon, sir.
I am sure that exists.
Nah, I know it exists.
I know some people were saying there's a fan game, like a hack of Red and Green where you're... Or Fire Red, Leaf Green, where you're a Rocket member.
That's cool.
That sounds really cool.
I agree. Welcome to the National Park.
I always liked the music here. Just the nice piano music.
Yeah.
Nice. Listen, can we go anywhere from here?
Yeah.
Right, so like up here?
You go... We'll
just go
straight north. To the right.
This way.
Right there. Yeah. Yeah, that little park that separates the scariest routes for us.
And then
we go up, and we're at E-Critique, and then we go, instead of going to the right when we leave, we go to the left. We'll be at new routes, new stuff to catch.
Cool!
Could change everything.
The entire world is our oyster, boys.
Yeah, there's a whole universe out there for us to catch.
Whole Poke universe.
Ed Butt!
And Mr. Steak's here to join us.
I feel it.
Mr. Steak!
We're getting close to left to level ups, or to evolutions, that I'm just like, just do every fight we can.
Yeah, yeah.
May as well. Even this one.
Look at, yeah, even this one. If it's standard, that'd be great.
It's quicker, it's quicker than running.
Headbutt will still kill
it. Yeah, no, you're not gonna kill us. You're half double, our level.
You're double the level.
At this point, Vulpix can't even know fire moves.
Poor little thing.
Could try a little
shit. It's misguided.
Boom!
Well, Mr. Steak, pound it to paste.
Technically, it could know Ember, but it doesn't.
That would not matter.
It forgets it in the wild.
That's so crazy.
It replaces it with Will-O-Wisp.
Wow, that's awful.
Out of the way, fat man.
And
so yes, by technicality, for all those internet commenters who want to be more right, I'm gonna go ahead and let them know. I'm aware it learns Ember at level zero.
Okay,
or
new route.
What's up? Hey.
I guarantee you're gonna have a bad day against us, sir.
I've been overseas. I know all about Pokemon.
That's nice.
You ever see Pokemon in Nam? Here, I got binoculars. I'm gonna watch you fight Wooper.
You've made a bad choice,
You're gonna have a bad
sir.
Time, dude.
Your day has gotten worse.
You made a mistake.
Not even enough to level up at that tiny
mess. Not even worth it. Let's see what we got.
Of course,
Mr. Steak will probably murder the shit out of whatever
Girafarig. Or Eradicate. We don't have one.
Let's catch it just so we don't have to catch it later. I hate it when that is the reason.
Yeah.
Cut. Do you have anything that
cut
wouldn't
kill it?
Kill it.
Yeah, cut's not gonna kill it.
Mr.
Really
Steak,
won't.
He's not used to using it.
He's like, how do I do? What is he cutting with? The leaf?
Probably the
leaf.
Probably the thing on top of his head. Think that's enough to catch it?
Yeah.
An Ultra Ball, certainly.
Not a great ball. Don't waste it. Ultra Ball for stuff we love.
Something we'd actually use.
I like the look of the Great Ball better.
Yeah, same.
I do too.
Just use it. It's...
Get hyper. I was gonna say, if this thing kills somehow.
That's almost impossible, though.
Does Olivine sell Ultras?
I don't know. Probably not.
What's Heavy
Regardless,
Ball?
We aren't, like...
Heavy Ball is if it weighs more.
Fine, whatever. It's Ultra Ball. But if we can't catch anything later, we'll be throwing Pokeballs. Your fault.
You always switch to a weaker Pokemon and weaken it more. Cut cheek.
Yay.
All
Goldenrod
right.
Goldenrod definitely sells Ultra Balls, though.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, Goldenrod does.
It's a girl, Martina.
In honor. She's just going to retire in the box anyway.
So she's practically dead.
Yeah, might as well be. Truly, this is the worst fate, if you think about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, just getting forgotten.
Trapped in stasis in the form of data.
Let's give you once, take a potion or
you
something.
You once knew what freedom Fuck. Was.
Fuck.
And we could have had Fuck. A Meowth.
Ah. I mean, I wouldn't have been prepared.
Meowth you was kind of a disappointment.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was. Sorry, kid. Maybe when you're older.
Goodbye.
First take! Mr. Steak!
Yo! Dang me! Bag you up.
There you go, Mr. Steak. Feeling a little better? Feeling confident?
He's feeling good.
Alright, let's murder this little girl.
Actually, I don't know about a head.
Oh, yeah.
We could get a Heracross.
Because I would fucking love a Heracross!
And you don't
get
it.
Oh, Ladybug! I didn't know we could get this. Oh no, we can't get
Spinarak.
Spinarak, that's what we can't get.
Ledian's kinda cool.
Ledian looks like a freaking Kamen Rider. Love Ledian.
Cut shouldn't kill.
Cut won't kill.
Hopefully.
It won't.
Oh, it did.
It did.
Mistake!
All right, you.
Good job. You know what, Mr. Steak? You did what you were supposed to do, and God damn it.
Guess we can't be too mad.
He made a Mr. Steak.
No, he didn't. He's looking out for us.
How dare you? On the same day.
Get out of here.
On our son's birthday, no less.
No, that was yesterday.
Birthday was yesterday.
Still his birthday. Every day's his birthday. Remember?
Yeah, I forgot. You were the one who didn't want to celebrate his birthday. How do you feel? Knowing that your son is better than you.
He's older than you now. He's 29.
Is he still a disappointment? Is he not going to be disappointed until he runs his own company?
Call me when you... when you're married and have kids and...
and are a magic doctor and save the president and are also the president.
When you save your... when you do emergency heart surgery on yourself to save your own life as the president and his most trusted surgeon.
The vice president.
I'm the president of doctors.
And then elect yourself to the Supreme Court. I don't fucking care. I'm done.
Throw the whole checks and balances out the window. Give me another drink while you're up, you dumb piece. Change the channel. I lost the remote.
You're really good with Pokemon.
I lost the clicker.
Boys give me items after battles.
I can share
some. Yo, you want to share some items, girl?
You want our digis. All right. Yeah. We'll give it to you. Whatever.
Have we set the precedent that Tantor only takes numbers from girls?
No, he's taking numbers.
No, he's everybody's best friend.
Okay.
He just hates them all.
He's a very social monster.
He's the surly friend that everybody has. It's like, why are we friends with him? And whatever. It's harmless. You know. We just don't want him to shoot us when he does go rogue.
So let me try something I learned today.
Oh, good job, idiot!
Yeah, look at him. No, that we knocked that over.
Mr. Babe.
Mr. Stink.
Yeah, you want to talk about who's the better Mister?
Mr. Mime!
He's thinking about it. He's considering the question.
He'll go away.
Mr. Stink!
Just don't pay attention to him.
Oh,
no.
Oh, God.
The true Mister.
Mr. Stink.
There's no mystery here.
Stink Jr.
Stupid kid. And we're gonna dump his books.
What did you learn? How to lose?
Sure.
No.
Yeah.
Not him.
He wants to talk about Professor Oak. What a...
Oh, yeah, no, dude. We're
a loser.
Professor Oak. Sorry.
Fuck you.
Yeah, well...
Get out of here,
kid.
Nerd.
Whatever, nerd. Move it, kid. I'm gonna knock over your...
I'm gonna dump your books.
I hate you, kid.
Stupid kid. Fuck!
That's the first one we said no to getting their vote number.
That
and
kid
a
was,
worthy
that kid
reason.
Was,
the kid was a break. Yeah.
The kid was a fucking nerd. He thought he could have a mister? Nah.
No.
Only one mister.
There's
here.
There's only one.
Yeah, we're the mister owner here. Ooh,
wow.
This meowth's a little bit spunkier.
I'm not a steak. I am the steak. And to you, I am Mr. Steak.
My friends call me Mr. Steak.
Heyo.
Good job, Mr. Steak.
Hey, girl, what's up?
Hi, aren't you a Q trainer?
Oh, I mean, if you say so.
Uh-oh.
Hi.
Valerie.
Hey, you look,
can you we look, call you Val?
You're like, what, 2 years older than us?
I mean, it's like, whatever. She's not older than us. We're older, like, we're around the same age.
Oh, yeah. She
we're 28.
Yeah.
We look very young for our age. Mom buys my clothes.
We shaved.
Tantor.
We
shaved. He's just nervous.
We shaved yesterday. Sorry for killing your Pokemon, Tantor.
When he gets nervous,
very mild Tourette's.
Shouts,
yeah, he's a very, very mild Tourette's.
One eye just starts blinking shut rapidly. Tantor!
You're very pretty, Tantor!
Do you think Tantor's a guy who blinks one eye at a time?
When he's nervous, probably.
Yeah.
But I don't see him getting nervous too often. Tantor!
I like the idea of, like, grown-up Tantor, where he has, like, slowly gotten himself, like, under control, and he's, like, giving a speech at, like, you know, like, some college dissertation, just be like, and then you'll see the evidence, Tantor, presents that...
Tantor! Presents a Tantor!
Yeah. Tantor!
Then Mr. Steak just busts in the room, Mr. Steak! Slams his head through the wall.
My associate Mr. Steak agrees.
Mr. Steak!
Just slams its head on his pen.
Slams his head on the professor's desk.
Yeah.
As you can see.
As you see, Mr. Steak's research has...
Exhibit A, not all Pokemon are created equal.
Mr. Steak! Magic Leaf, probably. Because you're
no,
using...
I think grass on steel sucks.
Well, you're using physical moves on steel, which sucks also. At least you get a stab.
That's more than... Watch. Doesn't do more than me.
Thanks, Edward.
It does?
It's not very effective.
Neither was anything else.
It didn't say the text.
It did.
No, it didn't.
Yes, it did.
No, it did.
Every time you hit it, said
it. I'm gonna play the footage back. I'm gonna scrub the footage so it doesn't say it.
Now we can't trust anything.
One thing you can trust, though, is that we will see you guys next time on TFS Plays Pokemon Soul Silver Nuzlocke.
Hey everyone, just kind of wanted to hop into the fan art since that is my favorite part of the episode. I hope you guys enjoyed what you saw because this was quite a tumultuous episode with two deaths and an insane gym battle. Hope that makes up for our lack of deaths and challenges lately. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, leave a like at the bottom and let us know. But without further ado, let's get off to the real star, and that is you guys out there drawing some amazing fan art for us. So I'm going to go ahead and give a highlight to all the ones that were submitted to me on Twitter. If I happen to miss any, human error, man. Like, there are so many that I get all the time that even my notifications run out, so I did my best to see whoever I could get. So first off, let's kick it off with a staple. We have here one from Morgane Sky. I love the chibi Tantor and the little Samara falling right behind him. Thank you so much for your continuing work, Morgane. You're wonderful. Thank you so much for that piece. We have another one here from Isaiah Gardner of Salad Fork, finally being terminated, and Tantor doesn't care. They will not be missed. I love the interpretations of Tantor. Pretty much unanimously across the board, he's just this brutal, brooding dude. So thank you all so much for keeping that up. That was great, Isaiah. Thank you so much. Here's one from Christina Gray at Dragon Ball Z Girl. She has Slowmara drowning Salad Fork as she does with Surf. I like to imagine that the water rises up to where she can just dunk them under till the bubbles stop. And it's absolutely fun one. Well, not really fun, depends on your sense of humor, but I thought it was great. Thank you so much, Christina. We have one here from Trent J. Smith, said it a while ago, back when we first started, but I must have missed it. But I wanted to give a highlight to it because this one is fascinating. Has Scrotum here just losing a battle. Not bad for someone so weak. Tantor, of course, he doesn't know who the heck he is. Mr. Steak shows up and then bam, decks him in the face. Thank you so much for that one, Trent. That is super fun. Let's go ahead and move on to one from Detective Ichigo. Remember when Man-Crobat was just eating all, or I'm sorry, no, Man-Fruit-Bat was eating all of Morty's ghosts, and we had him whenever he opened his mouth, you could see the damned souls trying to escape. That's horrifying and a lovely depiction, Detective Ichigo. Thank you so much for that one. We have another creepy one here from Jenica Hogg at Jenica Hogg with Slowmara entering the battlefield. I imagine this is her character select screen. She looks absolutely terrifying, and I would never want to see her in a dark room with a static TV. Thank you so much, Jenica. That one's really fun. Here's another one from Chris Chavez at the Dark Spade. He's got another Slowmara there. Just looking real creepy. I love all the little line art and saying slow in the background. Super fun one, Chris. Thank you all so much. Keeping up the Samara love, we have one from Taylor Friedhoff at the Life on Mars 73 with Slowmara coming out of the well. What better way to have her approach than from her own location? And she can appear anywhere she wants, but the well, there's something comfy about it. Thank you so much, Taylor. That one was spectacular. Here we have another submission from Master Hirano at Master Hirano on Twitter with Mr. Steak and all the little bruises on his head from having to headbutt all those trees. But look at him. He can't tell what's going on. He loves it, and we love it too. Thank you so much, Master Hirano. Another creepy one from Kerbibble Gaming at Kerbibble Gaming. We have Slowmara looking absolutely demented, ready to murder anything she possibly can, as we have seen with her warping reality. Hopefully that doesn't happen soon. Gone for a pretty long time, but watch me jinx it right ahead. Thank you all so much for that submission there, Kerbibble Gaming. I loved it. Here's another one from Cat at Many Faces of Cat. This comic here has everyone trying to walk through, and then somebody, Dwaylen stops. Looks for something or someone. And then Ally McBeal and Slowmara try to console him. See if Slowmara isn't all bad. They all try to console Dwaendalyn. He goes, okay, fine. Then Dwaendalyn turns around and he can see the ghost, or she can see the ghost of Salad Fork. And then Salad Fork says to Twildane that I'm happy and tell Queen Stink that I'm happy. She's the queen I never was. And Salad Fork, you are not missed. And then Slowmara walks away. And I love the comic ones. Thank you so much for that one there, Cat. That one was really fun. Here's another comic from Angry the Third at The Real Alex Q with Slowmara again appearing, a dead Salad Fork and Martin. And Slowmara's become so strong. She's becoming so strong. I don't think you've understood how much she can warp reality. And this is in that one episode where she first warped it thanks to Grant calling her name. Thank you so much for that one, Angrier the Third. Here's another one from Fumbleton. I'm just the crew, everyone hanging out. Tantor being his lovely self with Mr. Steak, Ally McBeal, Man Crobat, pre-evolved Dwendalyn, our favorite son Ivan, and Slomar. Little Red Gyarados thinking he's going to be part of the party. Too bad. You're not. Here's another one from TJ Crooks. Possibly my favorite. This is where we have Tantor, for all of you that don't know about the lore. Tantor walks in on his mom banging the delivery guy constantly. Tantor's estranged sister doesn't know what to do and tries to take care of her mother, who won't take her to her medication. Tantor walks in as a child, and Tantor, honey. Oh, man. His name is Tantor. He says, I thought you were sleeping, says Tantor. Geez, didn't you knock? And then Tantor slammed the damn door! And that's where he decided to be Tantor for the rest of his days. A traumatic event that would forever resign his ability to talk. TJ, I love all your comics. Thank you so much for keeping them in. Here's another one from Ash Pash at The One Ash Pash on Twitter. If I can warp the world itself, I will break you. I love Slomar there, looking creepy. Thank you so much, Ash Pash. Then we have here another another terrifying one from Rory Fiddler of Slomara hanging down from the top of a ceiling. I would never want to walk in a building and see that. In fact, I might just burn the whole building down. I think that's the safest thing to do. Thank you so much for that one, Rory. Here's another one from Nicholas Doyle when we mentioned that Morty's ghosts would be food for our man Crobat, and he just devoured all of them, and you can see them all trapped, but they're not going anywhere. Here's another one from Hulk the Hero. We have a little well over here with Salad Fork and Martin written into it, and this is where the Pokemon who failed Tantor go. They will not be missed. As he follows up on his second iteration, we have Slomara coming out of a computer and dragging Salad Fork away. So make sure you look behind and check that Salad Fork isn't gonna be right behind you. Here's another one from Focus at Focus 11 of Tantor, beefing up, ready for the fight against the Kyogre. And I love that people have taken to putting the red rocket R on the top of his head, because we all kind of know he's a villain. And we'll see if he gets his comeuppance. Here's another astounding one from Fantor at The Fantor, with these two creepy trainers that Tantor runs across. And he puts his hands on them and says, you know what? It's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. Maybe just crushes their heads. It's not okay. I love Tantor just being the monster that he is. And keeping up with the trend of Tantor being part of Team Rocket, we have one here from Young Sebek at Young Sebek, but he has it branded on his forehead, and he's being so rude, he's flipping us off. Why would he ever? He absolutely would do that. He totally would do that. Thank you so much for that one, Young Sebek. That one was really fun. Here's another one from Eric Lovelock. He said he loved upping the creep factor of every character. He's got the main trio, really. I think we can all call him that. We got Ivan on the left, Mr. Steak in the center, and Slomara on the right, looking absolutely terrifying. Then we have one here, if you guys remember the lore of the delivery man banging our mom. We have Gregory Kays at Red Cooler showing the delivery man showing up with a special package from our mom. His name is Jeff, and he's a cheeky asshole. Don't answer him if he calls you. Here's another one from Captain Skipjack, back at it again with the first issue of Man Crobat. I love it. He's got the Man Bat motif, but it's Man Crobat, so it's that much better. Thank you so much, Captain Skipjack. I love all your submissions. This is a little different. This is from Kevin at Kevderman, where he said, can I use Lekeager in my military fiction? And so it's got Lieutenant Lekeager with his own Bork laser ready to fire. Thought that one was super fun, and it was pretty great. This one's from our Pokemon Uranium stream, if you guys haven't caught that yet. We have our lovely Schmuddle, who starts off as a cub bug, and then evolves into, I don't remember what it is, but it's absolutely adorable, and you can see Tantor losing his mind over there. Killchan, nowhere to be found. Thank you so much, Batoga. That was great. Here's one from Philip Smith at Smith PJ Smith 97 on Twitter. And he's got Ivan Ooze celebrating his birthday with his number one son, Mug. Mr. Steak's in the background, but no one cares about Mr. Steak. It's not his birthday. It's Ivan's birthday every day. And here we have another one from Shane Alessi with more art of Ivan's birthday and Mr. Steak getting the shaft. Did we mention Mr. Steak not having a birthday? Because there were quite a few of those. Here's another one from Rick McBighands at The Boat Among Us, with Ivan lovingly opening his present by catching it on fire. Thank you so much for that one, Rick. That was great. Here's one from Zarzamon from a while ago. You get to see a little Tantor and a cute, adorable little Mr. Steak over on the side. Thank you so much for that one, Zarzamon. That one was pretty fun. Here's another one from Hugh Dawson at Hugh Dawson on Twitter, of the evolutions of Mr. Steak, starting from his Chikorita to his Bayleaf and then to his, I don't know. That sounds about right. I think his neck just gets longer. Then he can whip it around and use it for fly. That'll be great. Here's another one from Matt Fay at the Fay 25 of his idea of Man-Crobat and what he's absorbed all the souls with the eyes everywhere. And now he looks like a monster from Berserk. And to be honest, I kind of wish Crobat looked like that. That's fantastic, Matt. Thank you so much for your contribution. Here's another from Brittany Ann Taylor at Britannica24. Little Ivan celebrating his birthday, and he's having such a good time and eating the little Fire Blast TM that he so lovingly got for his birthday present. Thank you so much for that one, Brittany. And to wrap it all off, we have one spectacular one from Ikrodway, I think that's how you say it. He has a comic here of Lakiger sitting atop Mount Silver. I see, he already has 4 badges. It looks like they sent me a formidable challenger, a true challenge. Then Tantor at the bottom with Mr. Steak. Sorry, that's not exactly how it's gonna work. I'm hyped for the Lakiger versus Tantor battle, and if you are, make sure to leave a like down at the bottom. If you want to send in some more fan art, shoot it at @KiraNSA _ is the easiest way for me to keep track of it, because if I had to go through everything, it would be a nightmare. So I select the ones in there, because you guys are the true fans. Thank you all so much for your support. We'll try to keep it coming this weekend. Thank you all, and have a great rest of the day.